Hallo, welcome to this video of Martin Me. My name is Gilles van der Meij. I will give you in this video an overview of classification societies. Starting with history and why there is a classification society nowadays. Different kind of surveys and intervals will be shown. And there is also written in the website, and the link is shown below this video. Different surveys for the flag states are also shown in the end of this video. So let's start with the background of the class societies. The first class society has origin in Edward's Cafe. The captains there inspected ships in the port of London, and there was the cafe in residence to give their clients, the merchants and the underwriters, an insight of the quality and the seaworthiness of the chartered ships. This led to the first class society, Lloyd's Register, and it was established in 1760. From the beginning of 1800, more societies were started. About a century later, the class society started to work for the owner of the ship instead of the underwriter of the cargo. Nowadays, SOLAS makes a classification society mandatory under the chapter of construction, paragraph 3.1. Design constructed and maintained in compliance with the structural, mechanical and electrical requirements of a classification society which is recognized by the administration. So at the moment there are 50 different classification societies. These 12 joined the IAX, the International Association of Classification Society. Each classification society has need their own set of rules. Here you can see the DNVGL, and the rules should be have the electrical rules for design according to the requirements of SOLAS. The survey intervals of the classification certificate is following the harmonized system. It's a construction certificate from the flag state. It's more or less the same certifying as the classification certificate. The intervals of these two inspections are all more or less the same. Here you can see the booklet of the survey stuff. This means every year an annual with three months and before and after the annual anniversary date. The second and the third year the annual survey is extended to an intermediate survey with the same window. Normally a dock has to be scheduled, except when the ship is designed for diving inspection of the hull. The class renewal will be after 5 years, and this needs a dry docking. The 5-yearly dry docking can now be extended to 7.5 years for special designed ships. This means that a new vessel with a correct design and consent of the flag state has the first 15 years only 2 instead of 3 dry dockings. After that, the interval remains every 5 years. The classification society is in most cases involved in the different kind of surveys, audits and flag state inspections. First, the class will always focus on their own surveys which are required for the classification certificate. And there are different ones. Surveys during new building when the yard is in the client. The new building surveys including all component surveys during the lifetime of the ship. The regular surveys for the certificate, like the annual intermediate renewal boilers, dry docking, diving surveys, the propeller surveys, also the continuous survey for machinery, hull, reefer. There are surveys for transfer of class, condition surveys, rectification of condition of class, damage surveys, and as soon as there is a damage, the class society has to be informed by the master or the manager of the ship. Most of the underwriters are interested if the class will approve a certain repair. Besides these repairs, surveys for the flag state, if the flag state authorized the classification surveyor to inspect for the flag, then this are the inspection during the new building, including initial for load line safety equipment, safety the lifetime of the ship, all the statutory surveys are done depending on the agreement with the flag state. So load line, safety construction, equipment and radio. This radio normally needs a separate radio surveyor. Also the MARPOS 1-2-6 and rectification of deficiencies, assisting the client if the port state stops the vessel. Necessary surveys during flag state of owner management and name. ISM audits, ISPS audits, MSC inspections. Probably there are some surveys missing in this list, but in most cases the classification survey can answer your questions when they are visiting your vessel for any kind of survey. Thank you for watching this video, and please, if you like to see more, inscribe yourself to this channel. Goodbye.